Pray God you can cope. I stand outside. This woman's work, this woman's work.
Cheese.
Cheese.
Okay. You're welcome. You're a good boy.
Now starts the cry of the
father. You are cheeky, aren't you?
At the tender age of 2, Caius Harris should have the world in his hands.
Not what you imagine. You imagine, you know, having a perfectly healthy child. And, yeah, well, you know, that's what every parent sort of hopes for.
It's only been a few months since he was diagnosed with a fatal genetic disease known as Sanfilippo syndrome, a syndrome that will rob those diagnosed of life before they even get a chance to experience it in all its beauty. Looking at Caius now, it's hard to imagine that this adorable boy's future holds a painful and premature death.
You have all these hopes and dreams, and you imagine them going to school and getting married, and when you sort of look that far ahead now, well, I can't.
Oh, darling, make it go. Make it go away.
Sanfilippo children are born deficient in an enzyme that prevents their tiny bodies from going through its natural recycling process. As a result, waste builds up in their cells, particularly the brain. It then turns toxic, causing severe and irreversible brain damage. As the disease progresses and their health deteriorates, that inner spark that shines so brightly in Sanfilippo children is slowly extinguished. Their life expectancy, just 12 to 18 years.
They've gone from great expectations of a child at birth, with all of the hopes of having grandchildren, now to be confronted with the death of their child before they get to their 20s.
It's rare. So rare, in fact, it only affects around 1 in 70,000 births. But for these families, it's all they know. It's become their everyday reality, a living nightmare.
It defines us now, and it defines Mackenzie.
That's Mackenzie Olofsson.
Oh, you feel my lungs of sweetness.
6 years old and a gorgeous bundle of energy. She's one of a kind, unforgettable.
When she has an encounter with anybody, they always walk away remembering her.
And she's a Sanfilippo child.
It's hard to see the future. It's very difficult for us to imagine her different from how she is now.
Then there's 5-year-old Sky Robson, a little girl with such a beautiful soul. She'll face a similar crippling fate.
She's done nothing wrong. She doesn't deserve this. No one deserves this. It's just rotten luck. It really is.
With no proven treatment and no cure.
If we could find something that improves her quality of life, you know, just makes her happy, you know, that prevents her from having to go through the pain that she will go through, you know, I'd do anything for that. You know, as a father, that's the last thing you want to see your child go through.
3 families, 3 children, just 3 of many more that you can help today. Because where there's life, there's hope. And that's where the Sanfilippo Children's Foundation comes in. It's the life's work of Megan Donnell. She set up the foundation after discovering not one, but both of her precious children, Isla and Jude, have Sanfilippo. Since then, their tragic story has gone global, helping to raise more than $1 million driven into groundbreaking research. But they need $1 million more.
And so this is a long haul.
We march with the midnight sun.
Scientists have identified the specific genetic mutations responsible for this hereditary condition and believe they've found a treatment, even a cure. It's called gene therapy, and initial clinical trials have proved promising, their best hope yet. But first, the foundation needs to raise enough money to fund the potentially life-saving human clinical trials in the US and Europe. Then they want to bring the human trials here to Australia so that our children can have better access.
We're that far away. I mean, the condition's been cured in mice. We're that far away from finding a cure.
With a cure just on the horizon, this is a race against time. Not only to save future Sanfilippo children, but to stop the disease dead in its tracks for those already in its grip.
Our hope is that people will see how urgent the situation is for us and every other Sanfilippo child.
Amid the black clouds, a silver lining. These families are strong, they have no choice, but their overwhelming positivity and unyielding faith that a cure will be found is an inspiration for us all.
At least, as far as I'm concerned, that gives a massive amount of meaning to Skye's life. You know, her legacy will be that other children don't have to go through this sort of thing. Other families don't have to go through what we're going through.
While the enormity of what lies ahead is almost too hard to grasp, with your compassion and generosity, something can and will be done. Because of you and these incredible families, the fight is well and truly alive. And until no child or sibling or mother or father ever has to endure the devastating condition that is Sanfilippo, then each and every day is a gift.
I look at him now and see what a happy little boy that he is, and he brings so much joy to my life.
My darling, please make it go away. Make it go away.
Every day right now is precious, and basically every day is what we can do while we can do it.